Hello and welcome to the Young Turks Dream Decade. I'm Shireen Bhan. Over the next 30 minutes, we continue to put the spotlight on successful e-entrepreneurs in the country. On YT Gets Real, we travel the length and breadth of India to bring you young entrepreneurial stories that are trying to do something differently. And on the YT Buzz, we wrap up everything that's hot and happening and worth talking about on the entrepreneurial scene. Here's a quick glimpse of what we have lined up. Is giving India's unbanked a chance to get a financial identity through FINO, or Financial Inclusion Network and Operations. It's a venture started by Manish Khera, and the idea really is to provide banking services to those who cannot access regular banking services. The method is through the use of biometric cards, handheld devices and other such schemes. Now, FINO already has 35 million customers and it's done a turnover of 200 crore rupees. No wonder then that global private equity giant Blackstone has just invested 150 crore rupees into the company. We sent out Kritika Saxena to find out more about FINO's future.
Financial inclusion is the government's stated priority, but reaching out to the unbanked, especially in rural India, is a daunting task. One of the biggest challenges is last mile connectivity, and that's the gap Manish Khera is hoping to bridge with his venture FINO, Financial Inclusion Network and Operations. What started in 2006 as a tool to help financial institutions acquire low income customers at their doorsteps, FINO today offers financial and non-financial products like saving bank accounts, loans, recurring deposits, insurance products and government disbursements to the unbanked rural Indians. Assisting branchless banking through biometric smart cards, handheld devices and micro-deposit machines, FINO today is a market leader with 90% market share and 35 million micro-customers across 15,000 transaction points in 24 states. Pat Manish believes it's not the scale but distinct approach that has proved to be the game changer for FINO.
Two things which broadly are being redefined if you go deeper into the system. Mm. One is to say that let's change the approach from being a passive service provider to a proactive service provider. If you draw a parallel to the retail boom which happened on the banking side, the retail growth which happened on the banking side, the key difference from the earlier approach to the new approach was that rather than the customer coming and selling themselves to the banks, we had a DSA kind of a entity being introduced. Mm. Who was making sure the customer could engage with the bank in a friendly manner. Secondly, while the ownership of the customer is being maintained with a larger well-regulated entity like a bank, let's say, the delivery is happening through a low-cost channel. What you needed was is a very strong technology architecture. Mm. So whether you call it a card and device-based system, or you can do a mobile-based system, or you can do a branch-based system, some engagement with the customer on the ground, then you have a huge transaction system. So we went out and started enabling each one of these pieces. What will be the technology which will go out? What will be the this agent system which will go out? So we enabled all that.
Manish, a bit on your, on FINO's Tatkal initiative, how does this work? Give us a breakup of how the whole Tatkal initiative pans out.
We have set up the same banking point, the business correspondent point, in urban areas as well as in the rural areas. The customer can, on this end, on the remitter end, open a bank account. On the remitting end also, we open a bank account. So money gets transferred from point A to point B through two bank accounts.
Okay.
So you deposit money in the urban areas, your family can withdraw in the rural areas in the same instance. So today the product is focused on you deposit money into your bank account in the urban areas, you withdraw the money from another bank account in the rural areas instantaneously and mimic a remittance product.
Okay.
But underlying, this is in a way a foundation stone we are laying for the banking relationship to be built up.
How is the future of financial inclusion in India looking like currently?
There are estimated 300 to 500 million people who do not have access to financial services. As I said, we are 90% of the market. Going forward, there may be other people. And hopefully in the next 2 to 3 years, we would have saturated the market as a system. That means everybody who wants to do financial services, banking, would have got access to financial services.
Incubated by ICICI Bank, Fino today partners 23 banks, 17 government entities and 4 insurance companies. Acquiring 50,000 new customers every day and facilitating 3 million transactions every month through its network of 20,000 agents, Fino has registered a turnover of 200 crore rupees in 2011. To drive future growth, Manish recently raised 150 crore rupees from global private equity firm Blackstone.
The money will be used for our growth. So on one dimension, we are growing in terms of our customer base. And we do see, say, internally, that we add a Fino every year. We were 5 million 3 years back, then at 13.
Absolutely.
So we added 8 on a base of 5. And then we grew to 30 million customers. So we added practically the same number of customers which we added till date. And we are hoping this year again we'll add a similar kind of a number. On the second dimension, we are going deeper with the customer. We are offering more and more products to them. As we grow on these two dimensions, we'll require more money.
So there is an option of possibly looking at a larger amount of funding coming in from
I am as of now only on this 150 crore that we have raised. So we will invest more in our field infrastructure on the transaction point. We will invest more in our back-end infrastructure, both on the technology and the operations side. So that will grow. Today we are aiming to add, take this 35 million to 100 million customer base by 2015. And we are also looking at global markets to expand.
What are the markets that you are looking at?
Well, largely Southeast Asia and Africa.
Will you look at increasing the employee base going forward? You have around...
We will double this year itself.
So from 20,000 people
was March. We are already at 25. We'll go to 40 by this March. We are on our way by 2015 to become a company employing 1 lakh people.
How do you see the role of financial inclusion to bridge the gap between the bank and the unbanked? How do you see that till 2015?
We would have, as a system, made sure that any willing customer has an opportunity to engage with the system. There are some fundamental blocks which have been set up in the country. And I think they will start playing a role more and more here. Credit bureaus, as a block, I would say, in the same vein, that makes sure that we know who's a good customer and who's a bad customer. That will facilitate making sure the money is available to the right customer at the right price fastest. The right price will be decided by the owner of the customer, the bank.
Absolutely.
And they do have schemes which make money available to the customer at a rate far lower than the alternate ways which are available currently in the system. The past will be determined by somebody like us who will be delivering to the customer sitting right at the doorstep of the customer.
What are the challenges then?
The on-ground execution, that is very, very difficult. Simple infrastructure challenges, I would say, power, water, just not being there. You have to find alternates, to doing it. Connectivity is still a challenge. If my device is not a rechargeable device, I'm trying to service a customer using PCs and all that, I know I'm going to run into challenges. This cannot work. We don't have power there. So that's a very big challenge.
Named a young global leader by the World Economic Forum for groundbreaking work in financial inclusion, Manish is now betting on breaking through to the next frontier of mobile banking.
What role will m-commerce, mobile commerce play in this whole roadmap?
From a customer convenience perspective, a mobile architecture today is far more cumbersome than a card device architecture. So the trade-off is between, cost and customer adoption or customer convenience. If the somebody comes up with an investment and makes a big investment in this space, maybe a card device architecture will work more. Maybe if somebody is not able to do that and customer forcefully has to learn a not convenient architecture, they'll do that. Or maybe going forward, 3 to 5 years down the line, somebody may come up with an architecture which is customer friendly. And for sure, a mobile based system has a lower cost, then that will click. So there are various things being tried in the market there, but still all that is 3 to 5 years away is my take.
Thank you so much for speaking to us. And of course, all the best for the road ahead. You are planning to double your growth. You are planning to exceed this market share. So good luck to you for that.
Thank you so much.
Manish, here's wishing you and Fino the very best of luck. Time for us to take a break, but before we go, here are stories of some other entrepreneurs who are working towards improving or enhancing financial inclusion.